Hi everyone and welcome. I have had this request so many times and I haven't done it. Someone else did a try after reading my recipe and it didn't really turn out that well. So I've finally given in. I actually went to buy some coffee just so that I could actually make a video of how I'm making my famous egg coffee. Now, in this recipe, I'm making quite a lot of coffee. I have a jug that is 800 milliliters, so you will get a bunch of coffee out of that. I'm adding 3 eggs to that, so you don't have to add that much, and there is no hard set rule for how much you need to add. But you can just do a little bit what you want. I do recommend that you're adding butter, and the reason I do that is just because it makes it more filling. It's a much richer taste. Otherwise, I think it tastes a little bit watery. I'm also adding salt, and that is totally optional. For some people, they think that it tastes like coffee soup when you're adding salt. It's more savory. I'm used to drinking snake juice, but even before that, I always added salt to my coffee. I just like it better. It's the same. It has the same effect as the butter for me. So you will have to experiment a little bit with that, but I'm just going to show you how I'm doing it, and this is how. You will have to excuse the footage. It was a little bit dark in my kitchen, but that was the best I could do on the day. So here we go. So first of all, if you're going to make egg coffee, you obviously need coffee, and the way I'm making coffee is just that I think this is an 800 milliliter jug that I'm making it in. So I already put my coffee in there, fill it up with water, and then I let it stand there for about 5 minutes. I don't like to leave it for any longer than that personally, because I'm, as you might know, I like sugar, I like sweet, I don't like bitter. So 5 minutes is my maximum. Then I'll get my eggs. So I'm having some free range eggs here. And for this amount of coffee, I like using 3 eggs. So that's what I'm going to put in here. And you'll have to excuse the camera angle a little bit. I noticed it later on that it might have been a little bit low, but you can probably see anyway what I'm doing. So I'm putting 3 eggs into my jug, and I also want some butter because it's making it much more rich and filling. So that's my butter. It's roughly a tablespoon and a half maybe, so that's unsalted grass-fed butter. And then I personally like adding salt. Now you can't see me adding salt, but I am adding salt there. So that's just sea salt with iodine, actually, that particular one. And the reason I'm adding salt is that I like the taste. And then some sweetener. I'm using Stevia. I find that that's probably one of the best sweeteners. I'm not a huge fan of sweeteners normally. That's why I've stopped drinking coffee. But here we go. So maybe a quarter of a teaspoon. What I showed you, it did get a little bit. I actually added a little bit more than that later on, but you didn't see that. So after the 5 minutes are up, I just press the coffee, and now I'm gonna change the camera angle here because I noticed that you didn't see anything. So here we go. You just add the coffee while you're whisking. So you do it very slowly, just a little bit at a time. So make sure you are whisking it at the same time. So you need all that air coming in and cooling it down quickly. Otherwise you will get scrambled eggs and you don't want that. And that's it. Then you have egg coffee. And as you can see, there is a lot of foam. Some people like it. I love it. Some people don't want it. If you don't want it, you can just stir it away. It goes away pretty quickly. And this is what it looks like when you're done. So coffee looks like almost like a normal cappuccino or latte or whatever you're having. I don't drink that sort of coffee. There you go. Okay, so that is my egg coffee. Is it perfect? I don't know. I really like it. I'm not wasting anything. I'm using all the eggs. I'm using the yolk. I'm using the egg white. If you're using just egg yolks, which you can do, it might taste better to you. I've tried to add more egg yolks. It might be a little bit richer, but you know, I don't like wasting food at all if I can help it, especially when it's nutritious food. No, there's not a lot of nutrition in the egg white, but we do have animals who have to lay those eggs for us. So I think that, in my opinion, I should be eating those proteins. Hopefully, by adding the hot coffee, I'm activating some of the avidin in there so that I'm actually getting more nutrients out of it. So I hope that you have enjoyed this. If you like coffee, if you like egg coffee, if you don't, if you want to have a liquid breakfast that is actually made out of real food and you're a coffee drinker already, it's a brilliant way of actually getting some protein and fats in the morning. However, coffee might not be the best thing for everyone, or for anyone for that matter. I've stopped drinking coffee regularly mainly because I don't want to use sweeteners for nothing. Now I went to buy coffee just for you, so now I'm going to have to drink it all. So it's going to take me a few weeks to finish this packet, and I'm probably not going to drink it every day. I do like it, but I don't really miss it when it's gone. So thank you so much for watching. If you have any comments, if you have a variation on this, let me know. And if you're not subscribed already, please hit that subscribe button and like the video. I would really appreciate that. And also, you know, share it with everyone who you know. Some people are really struggling with the breakfast when they're going on a low carb diet and they're hungry, but they don't want to eat scrambled eggs every morning. This is a brilliant way of getting your eggs in, and you won't even notice it because you're drinking them. But one thing I do want to say about drinking food is that it is not as satiating as eating it. So I will see you very soon again. Take care.